Hello and welcome to another video. Today we're gonna read about another lesson, reading between the lines. Facts are statements that can be proved. Some texts contain facts and statistics. Statistics are facts that are based on research or surveys. Statistics are usually written as numbers of percentages. Phrases like experts say, research shows, and survey shows often introduce facts. The population of Angleston is increasing. Research shows that 20% of the population is under the age of 16. The population is bound to continue to increase. This is a fact. The population of Angleston is increasing. 20% of the population is under the age of 16. This is a statistic. It is a percentage based on data from research. The population is bound to continue. This is not a fact. It cannot be proved. An opinion is something the writer thinks. Opinions aren't true or untrue. They are just beliefs and can't be proved. Phrases like I think, I believe, or many people say show a statement is an opinion. I think music should be available to download for free. It's important that everyone has access to music. This is another opinion, is the writer's belief. I think shows this is an opinion. It can be hard to tell the difference between fact and opinion. If you're not sure whether something is a fact or an opinion, think about whether it can be proved or not. If it can, it is a fact. If it can't, it is an opinion. Opinions can be presented to look like facts. This makes them seem more believable. The majority of companies would be more efficient if they spent more money on IT. This sounds factual, but it can be proven. Let's practice some questions. Read each statement and write fact or opinion next to each one of to say whether the statement is presented as a fact or an opinion. Research shows that 60% of the UK population are overweight. Opinion. Women are generally better at dieting than men. Fact. I think 9 out of 10 people would say they like chocolate. Opinion. Surveys show that children with siblings are better at sharing. Fact. Let's see. Read the text below and then answer the questions underneath. The success of the smoking ban. In July 2007, smoking was banned in public places in England. This was the most sensible decision made by the government in years. The ban was popular with the majority of the population. In a survey, 70% of people said they still support the smoking ban. It is now much more pleasant to go into a pub or a restaurant. Before the ban, pubs were filled with smoke, which made you cough and made your hair and clothes smell. However, according to a study, 60% of bar and pub owners noticed a significant drop in business when the ban was introduced because smokers were staying at home rather than going out for a drink. Making smoking in public places illegal has had a positive impact on people's health. Since the ban, nearly 2 million people in the UK have given up smoking and the number of heart attacks has fallen by more than 40%. The benefits have also affected non-smokers. For example, the number of children suffering from chest infection has decreased by 20%. There are 6 statements from the text in the table below. Put a tick next to each statement to show which are presented as facts and which are presented as opinion. In July 2007, smoking was banned in public place in England. Fact. This was the most sensible decision made by the government in years. Opinion. In a survey, 70% of people said they still support the smoking ban. Fact. It is now much more pleasant to go into a pub or a restaurant, opinion. Since the ban, nearly 2 million people in the UK have given up smoking, fact. The number of children suffering from chest infection has decreased by 20%. Give another example of a statistic from the article that is not in the table. People are banned from public places all the time. Yeah, it might be. Let's see, reading between the lines. Writing isn't always balanced. Sometimes a writer has a point of view, an opinion they want to get across. They try to influence the reader by only giving their opinion. This is called bias. You can spot bias in a text if the writer exaggerates sometimes or ignores the other side of the argument. Let's see this text. North Coast Trains is the worst train company in Britain. Their trains are never on time and they are always overcrowded. Last week I had to stand for a 6-hour journey, which was just great. The first sentence is an opinion. Many people might disagree with it. The text ignores the fact that other train companies have trains that aren't on time and are overcrowded. The writer doesn't actually mean it was great, they mean the opposite. This is irony. Here it makes the reader understand how angry the writer is feeling. Bias isn't always obvious. A writer might seem to talk in a neutral way, but only actually give one point of view. Biased texts use different methods to influence the reader. A text might use humor to entertain the reader. This makes the reader like the writer. The new Hadawi sports car is the worst car I've ever driven. The engine is pathetic. I think my three-legged tortoise could probably move faster. This is a funny image. If the reader likes the writer, they are more likely to agree with their opinion. Biased text might use forceful language to make the reader agree with the writer. My meal was dreadful. The meat was stringy and disgusting. These words exaggerate how bad the food really was. Biased text might make claims that aren't supported with evidence. Everyone was delighted by the plans for a new car. It seems unlikely that everyone was delighted. Let's practice on the text. Read the text below and then answer the question underneath each one. Warhurst wins again. Michael Warhurst, the independent candidate for Gaversbury, has been elected for the third year in a row. Mr. Warhurst is the best MP Gaversbury has ever seen. He campaigned against the closure of Gaversbury General Hospital and fought the opening of a new Metro Market supermarket which threatened business and shops in the town center. Mrs. Warhurst will continue to campaign for the interest of the people of Gaversbury with the support of all the locals. Find one way the writer has tried to influence the reader opinion from the text above. A way the writer has tried to influence the reader is insisting Mr. Warhurst is the best. Example from the text. Mr. Warhurst is the best MP Gaversbury has ever seen. Maintain shampoo, beauty review online. Find two ways the writer has tried to influence the reader's opinion from the text above. Maintain shampoo, I'd heard good things about this shampoo, so I bought a bottle last week. But sadly, I was truly disappointed. Not only was I absolutely outraged by the price, but the product itself smelled horrendous. Despite the hideous smell, I tried washing my hair with it this morning, but it made my hair greasier than a plate of chips. I will not be buying this shampoo again. First way the writer has tried to influence the reader is by using her own experience. In sample from the text, made my hair greasier than a plate of chips. Second way the writer has tried to influence the reader is, I will not buying this shampoo again. So, if you like today my lesson about reading between the lines, don't forget to give me a like, a share and a comment below with your opinions about the lesson for today. Don't forget also to subscribe and click the button below to give me a thumbs up and also to subscribe to my channel Cristina Dumitru. Thank you very much for listening and have a good day. Bye bye.